All right, so take a look at this here. D5 has just launched the 2.7 version, and with it came a feature that for me fixes the biggest issue I had with D5, the scatter tool. D5 is a real-time render engine that can feel limited due to the lack of modeling capabilities, as opposed to, say, cycles with Blender or a render engine plugin that works on top of a 3D software, where you get a strong render engine with a powerful 3D software. So I understand that a real-time engine can only get so far with the scatter functionality. But really, this new scatter tool brings a more procedural approach to this task with maps and masks and layers and randomization, which just takes this to a whole nother level in my opinion. Let me show you what I'm talking about. By the way, feel free to subscribe to the channel if you like this type of content. Here we talk about architectural visualization and representation. And after this video, feel free to check out D5's official release video because there's more news about this update, but so far there's no actual tutorial on the scatter tool yet. That's why I decided to come in here and show you around. This video is not sponsored or anything, I was just super hyped about it, so I decided to share here on the channel. So before this update, you had to use the old scatter tool. No customization, no parameters to work with, very, very limited. And if we wanted to make changes, it had to be done all over again. I honestly just hated using this tool. Now we have this new scatter tool here. You can create a scatter based on the material or model. So far, the select material has made more sense in the occasions where I've tested. Then we pick the materials we want this scatter to attach to, and we can pick more than one material to really craft the surface we need, which is then why in a 3D software like SketchUp, for example, I often build the terrain like this, so to maximize my options when I go in and create the multiple scatters I'll use. Okay, so by material, and then let's pick this larger portion, plus this other here on top of the hill as well, and create. D5 now generates these little panels as sort of a grid that we can start to work with. As always, here in D5, it's over here on the inspector that we can work with the settings of the objects we select. But before I create something from scratch, let me show you something, because now there's a new category over the asset library called Scatter Presets. 33 options with this new release, but I feel that this will grow with the future updates. So you've got the global presets that holds both area divisions and content itself, and then the content presets, which just uses a single noise map. Now, since I already have this scattered created, we can only pick the content preset. So let me pick something here so that you start seeing the potential of this tool. Okay, it's gonna load. And as I'm testing this, I felt that this new scatter tool is much lighter and faster than the old one. Okay, done. Really cool, right? Let me turn off the panel so that you see the results better. No repetition whatsoever. This is really nice. Now, presets are great and all, but the real power is how far we can control and customize this. So let's take a look. We're gonna delete this one, and then let's create a new one from scratch. Okay, panels generated. And now instead of just adding the vegetation to this plane surface, we can further subdivide this area with this image divide option here. And then there's a whole lot of options to choose from. And this pattern that you're seeing here is applied over the small panels. So let's pick this one. And from the pattern chosen, we even have the option to dictate how many areas we want to work with. A lot of customization, as I'm saying. Let's go with 3 for now. Then each of these areas can hold a set of vegetation models. And then by clicking on these areas, they get highlighted so that you see how they look. So let's add a grass model to this. And then I'll go directly to the density to increase it. Fantastic. Now, this is an area that, in a sense, it is procedurally generated that picks and adds the grass model with variations, so that scale, position, rotation are all randomized based on a set of constraints to make it look real. That's exactly what we want. Then from here, we can pick as many models as we want to add to these areas. So a real grass, a real lawn or field like this would have some weeds, some flowers, some taller parts. And within each area, there's also a noise map that controls these clusters, as D5 calls. And we can tell how big the clusters are gonna be, also how rough they are with the cluster noise slider, and how these lines are defined more or less blur to mix them around each other. Then each of these individual models can have a rate of how much they appear in the area. We can set that rate, and this is the percentage of how much which is gonna be used. You can see what we're getting here, right? absolutely incredible. I can't say it enough how much I've been waiting for this type of solution in a real-time rendering software. More of these advanced capabilities that a Blender or 3ds Max have, but here in a software focused on architectural visualization. So let me fast forward a little bit here and fill up the rest of it with more grass variation. And as I do this, let me tell you that this tool needs a bit of a learning phase, and the result is just as good as your skills of creating realistic environments. So tons of references to understand how a real grass would look like. But this certainly makes an intimidating outdoor scene like this one that is essentially pure vegetation a lot more manageable. And I'm curious to test this on a more urban type of scenes, which I still believe will have a great impact on the final result. And I'm so happy with the fact that it can overlay multiple scatters on the same surface. So for example, this back area here, we can have a scatter of bushes, let's say. Now, this is obviously too dense, so that's where the masks come in. The colored maps that we saw earlier dictate the patterns of these multiple areas, but within each area, we can choose from a large library of masks to tell this scatter where we want the models to be placed on or not, like white reveals and black hides, just as a typical mask. And this overrides these clutter settings here, as far as I know. But then we also get the UV settings here to work with the position and size of this mask, allowing then even more customization. I mean, sure, you could add this by hand, especially these bushes or even the trees that I'm gonna add back here, but this allows you to quickly get random results, no time spent trying to avoid repetition as you would have spent manually adding these assets. Plus then you can always insert one more asset to the mix, remove or mix them up. Now, there's a bunch of these little settings to play with, like, for example, the collision slider control. Imagine like a bubble around the objects telling how close objects can be to each other that avoid overlaps, and you can control that. For example, a more spaced out scatter can be controlled with the density slider, but also increasing the collision volume. And now look, even after having this incredible new tool here in D5 that makes a scene like this achievable in no time, there's always going to be a need for a manual placement of objects. Remember that, like closer to the camera, it's easier just to manually add them, and even the ones behind the camera, they're going to be generating the shadows on the foreground. Okay, to finish this image, just one last scatter here, because why not? We can add leaves to the ground with the same workflow, just playing with masks and even working with the seed slider to get random results until we find something that suits the scene. And here's the final result after just 30 minutes playing with this image. If you're interested in learning more about D5 Render, I'm working on a new course that's going to be released soon. I'll leave a waiting list that you can sign up for in the video description. And depending on when you're watching this, the video might have already been launched, which then I'll make sure to update this link. Also in the video description, you'll find an affiliate link in case you're thinking about signing up for the pro version of D5, which is definitely worth it in my opinion. And by using the link, not only you get a discount, but you also support this channel. Okay, if you're interested in learning a new rendering engine and don't know which one exists or what are the pros and cons of these engines, here's the ultimate render engine comparison. Highly recommend watching it. See you in the next one.